This video will cover some of the considerations when working with literature in NVivo. This particular NVivo project was built over the last two videos, and as you can see here, I have a literature folder under the files area of data with 16 items within it. If I double click to open one of these, we can see this is a journal article. You'll notice bookmarks load on the left hand side for any tagged PDF. If you want to close this to create more space on your screen, just under the PDF tab choose bookmarks and this window will disappear. You can work with a PDF in NVivo much like any other type of data. So, for example, I can open my codes folder and begin to code this particular document for any themes that I begin to identify in this article and across others. This is just like any other file where I can highlight, then drag and drop into my codes area to create new codes or add to existing ones. Similarly, I can use coding stripes to visualize this coding as I'm working through. You can, however, spot one of the immediate concerns that because this article has columns, those coding stripes are very difficult to read without first clicking on them to see which column has the coding. I'm going to turn off this highlight and continue to code a little bit more. As you can see, I've only been going about this for a few seconds really, and I'm beginning to tease out some of the rich ideas already represented in this literature. If I close this article now, I can see, obviously, that only one file is represented here. But were I to go back and code all of my different files by this same framework, it would give me a really good feel which are the most common ideas in the literature and which and may be referred to in less places. Already you can see this is a great way for identifying gaps in the literature as well as strong trends and themes. I really recommend you look back at the earlier videos in this series on coding. It goes into much greater depth about coding and how you can do it and some of the different mechanisms to do it in NVivo. The next video will look at some of the queries we've already produced but some of the additional considerations we need to have when we're doing them on the literature.